Also, I prefer to have the set bonus for wearing all light armor, even if it looks a little dumb. And I forgot to crouch before stealing, which I wasn't paying attention to the top left. I hope I didn't just get a little bit of fine. It's not so much that I don't want to pay the fine as I don't want to have to go sneak back in and take my stolen goods back. Ooh, look at that. That's good. Yeah. Love when that happens. I don't know why. Okay. Well, let's head over to you. I need to visit Thieves Guild. Wait. What's this other objective here? Oh, okay. We'll see Blackbriar first, because I'll have to run back to the Thieves Guild after that anyways, I assume. And the other one's just for a side quest.
Ain't no doubt about it. Thieves Guild is back.
Whoa, what's going on? Good thing my controller wasn't near the damn desk. Just shook like I was being hit with an earthquake. Nothing happened. I guess a dragon came by through the sky or something. Alright, so looks like she's in here. Oh yeah, I remember. She was hanging about upstairs.
If you've got the coin, you've come to the right place. Pull up the seat.
Also, thanks to doing the whole peace treaty thing, Maven is the Jarl of this place now. I mean, if you're gonna have somebody run the town anyways, may as well have it be the person who runs it from the shadows.
I think you've had plenty, Volwolf. Maybe you should head on home.
This doesn't tell me much. The only thing that could identify Sabion's partner is this odd little symbol. Well, whoever this mysterious marking represents, they'll regret starting a war with me.
Oh yeah, crime war.
You should bring this information to the Thieves Guild immediately. There's also the matter of your payment. I believe you'll find this more than adequate for your services. Out of my way.
Oh boy, an Orcish Dagger of Harrowing. I can maybe get a few hundred gold off that. Like, at this point, the only thing I buy with the gold anyways is potions or soul gems so I can keep refilling. Well, I don't even need those now because I'm using my fists. We're buying houses and then, you know, for some reason working on crafting the houses even though it's doing nothing for me, especially since achievements are off. Sometimes you just want to build a house. Yeah, I need to know where my quest objective is. Why are you telling me to go back up there? I was gonna say, Brynjolf should be down here.
Word on the street is that poor Sabjorn has found himself in Whiterun's prison. How unfortunate for him.
Yeah. What you get for trusting an orc in a bear suit.
Now you're beginning to see how our little system works. Maven sent word that you discovered something else while you were out there. Something important to the guild? Then this is beyond coincidence. First Aaron.
Yeah, we got sabotage.
Now Sabjorn. Someone's trying to take us down by driving a wedge between Maven and the guild.
No honor among thieves.
Mercer thinks he knows a way to identify this new thorn in our side. He wants to meet with you right away. And if I were you, I'd hurry. I've never seen him this angry before.
Alright. I wonder if these stay... Oh, cool. So once I pick them, they just stay picked. I bet if I wait a little while, since then they'll refresh themselves. The master one kept... After I broke a lockpick, would reset the entire thing. So, I just gave up on that one. Like, 20 attempts is enough. Call it good. I don't need the treasure that badly. I do love picking up loot, but I can pick up plenty of loot laying around dungeons. Where am I going here? I guess I'll go return these valuables to Rex real quick. Get that off my thing.
Back with good news, I trust?
I mean,
out with it.
Fine. Yes.
I guess you'll need
I got the valuables, you give me the cash.
Good. We could use the coin. Come on, take another job so we can both make some money.
I'm doing the work. Why are you making the money? I like that the very first quest is you- oh, went in the wrong place. The very first quest is you fixing her fuck up. And then she's like, wait, but you suck, you're the newbie. Let's do some extra jobs, why don't we? And we'll both profit from it. Well, I can see where you're going with this, you son of a bitch. Oh, it's because it's a new... There we go. Let's say it's because it's a new quest. It wasn't automatically marked.
Ah, there you are. I've consulted my contacts regarding the information you recovered from Golden Glow Estate, but no one can identify that symbol. It would seem our adversary is attempting to take us apart indirectly by angering Maven Blackbriar. Very clever.
You admire them? Clever or not, they need to die.
Adversaries so easily. They're well funded, patient, and have been able to avoid identification for years. However, don't mistake.
You do realize you have like a terrible paper cut on your hand going on right now, there, buddy, right?
This is going to pay dearly. Because even after all their posturing and planning, they've made a mistake. The parchment you recovered mentions a Gajal lie. According to my sources, that's an old alias used by one of our contacts.
You don't say.
His real name is
Gullamon. Is the information about him written on that paper?
Gullamai is our inside man at the East Empire Company in Solitude. I'm betting he acted as a go-between for the sale of Golden Glow Estate and that he can finger our buyer. Get out there, shake him down, see what you come up with. Talk to Brynjolf before you leave if you have any questions.
Got it. Let's go visit Brynjolf, see what he can tell us.
I can't believe Gullamai's mixed up in all this. That Argonian couldn't find his tail with both hands. Trouble. Huh. He's one of the most stubborn lizards I've ever met. You have your work cut out for you. You're going to have to buy him off. It's the only way to get his attention.
Good thing I have all this extra gold.
Follow him and see what he's up to. If I know Gullamai, he's in way over his head, and you'll be able to use it as leverage. Have you asked him?
No, and I'm not about to either. I value my life.
Aye, he does indeed. And with his fingers in the East Empire Company's pie, we'll make good use of that debt. If I'm not being clear enough, that means we don't, for now. Just keep on his tail, and he's bound to step into something he can't scrape off his boot.
Oh, there we go. Easy as that. I mean, with as much damage as fists do, it's actually harder not to kill him. And you know, in a game like this, I can just take people out and whatever. I'll be able to still get through quests. But I do, you know, love games like, you know, Thief Dishonored. Stuff like that. Where your goal can be not to get caught. Not to fight at all. And just, you know, try to keep everybody alive. Oh. Can't wait for that objective to be back in town, and I just went the first way that I saw.
warm bed right about now.
Could be worse, buddy. Could be being attacked by vampires for the 100th time. Oh, I just had to go to solitude. Well, you know, extra loading screen. That's all that is. That was from one of the many attacks that keep going here. So vampires keep attacking everywhere, and I guess that's the thing that came with Dawnguard. Which I'm not super familiar with the newer DLCs, or the DLCs, because when I was playing this, it was just the game and then mods. And the DLCs kind of came along, and I was like, oh, whatever. I've got other RPGs to move on to, and then Legendary Edition came out, and I was like, wait a minute. Or Legendary, well... Legendary and then Special, and but Special is when I was like, alright, I'll sit down and play through this again. So now I'm giving the DLCs a go.
So, what do we have here?
And I got introduced to vampire attacks on cities all over the place. Well, that kills my NPCs at random, and I kind of like those people. So now what I do is, they die, I revive them, I get their inheritance, and they still get to go around and everything's fine. It's just a life insurance scam, I guess.
Now if you're looking for goods, you've come to the right person. Oh. Wait, did you say Golden Glow Estate? My apologies. I'm sorry to say I know very little about that. Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. All right. Had I known this deal would bring me this much trouble, I never would have accepted the gold. I was approached by a woman.
Always get your speech up. Makes dealing with these things a lot easier.
A bag of gold in my face and said all I had to do was pay Arengoth for the estate. I brought in the coin and walked away with her copy of the deed. Not at all. I tend not to ask too many questions when I'm on the job. I'm sure you understand. However, I did notice she was quite angry, and it was being directed at Mercer Frey.
Oh, shit.
In this business, we rarely deal in names. Our identity comes from how much coin we carry. Look, that's all I know. I never promised you I'd have all the answers. Now, since our transaction is done, I'll be on my way.
We're the only people around who aren't complete fools.
Go ahead. By all means. I'm just gonna go take a seat over here.
If you need a good rumor or two, I think I can oblige.
Look. This I look like the type of person who needs a drink.
In your dreams,
if I win, the next round's on you.
Ah, good to see you.
Should probably use Muffle right about now. Also had a ton of invisibility potions. Used them in a really stupid way and lost them all really quick. Oh shit, he's going quick. Whoop, a little faster. Alright, let's use my Assassin's Creed experience. All those tailing missions must have paid off, right? And I'm still being seen. By who? No one in the sky. Okay, the bird. There we go. Just in case I need it. Someone gets pissed while I have Muffle on trying to sneak. I need something to please stun them for about 2 seconds while I swap all my stuff. Ice Form's been my favorite thing because playing that axe build, I was just dying quite a bit to mages. So I just book it to the mage, Ice Form them, hit them, and then run and hide again until I could get to the next mage. Like, Ice Spike was sometimes a one-shot move, for the most part a two-shot move, or that ice wave spell, I don't know what the hell it's called. You shoot out an ice ball and it leaves a wave of ice behind it. One or two of those things, I'm gone. Even with this build, which is considerably better against all types of damage for some reason, still had trouble.
Go cast your fancy magic someplace else.
Don't you talk shit on my magic. Don't you call me fancy. See, the downside to tailing missions is, there actually isn't all that much going on here. Oh no, guy is walking ahead of me. Have to keep a certain distance so he doesn't turn around and say, "Hey, it's you, the man in the bear suit. I know you. I saw you at the bar 10 seconds ago. Why are you trying to blend in? Nobody else wears something like that, you freak." So the tail being detached reminded me of something. Dwarven crossbow bolts on here. Aw, what the hell? Hold on. There we go. If I stand up. Perfect. Dwarven crossbow bolts fit perfect right there. Down here, not so much. And then on Dawnguard armor, not at all. Which is the armor set the crossbows came out with. The crossbow bolts are hanging out like a mile away from my ass. Really don't like that blur. Don't know why it's a thing. It's like, is that what it's like for people who need glasses? Sometimes the blur just turns on. I guess in their case, the blur is always on. Oh god, I can't do that. Let's just do this. Feel free to go inside at any time, buddy. There we go. It's like I can't force him to go inside. Oh. Alright. I probably could have pickpocketed the key off of him or something. I'm gonna get ready for a bit of this. Never mind. Flawless execution. Can't do a novice, doing a master one easy. This looks like a ghost town. Fully expecting skeleton pirates to pop up. Looking for their magical gold doubloons that gave them immortality. You know, that was something that was strange to me with Pirates of the Caribbean. Okay, hello. No, mm-mm. You didn't see nothing. Whew. Probably should stay up above here. Also should probably do this. Nothing, nothing at all. Gonna come up here? Okay, cool. Don't know if I need to go higher or what. I may as well. It's probably safer up here. Seems like we're fine. Look, the perfect vantage to drop assassinate. I admit, I do love this free sneak experience. wonder if they, when they are, you know, if or when they put out the next Elder Scroll, what they'll do about Sneak being just utterly broken. Probably not much. You know, if people want to put their Sneak up to 100 and just walk around never being caught, fine. Walk in front of a dude and 30 times crit stab him, or 15 times or whatever. I think 30 times is only when you're from the back. I'm stuck. There we go. Oh shit. You didn't see nothing. You know that blur I was having? He must be having it too. There's no way you would see me standing in front of him, crouched, looking like this, and go, oh, whatever. Must just be a rat. I'd like to know who was detecting me there. Did you just turn around out of nowhere? He's skeptical. No. You always gotta have some buddies, don't you? Hope he doesn't turn right around, or this could be very problematic. What? What? No! No, don't go this way! What? Where are you going? No, come back. I think you were supposed to do something over here. You're going swimming? I don't think that's where you're supposed to go at all. No, don't worry about it. That was just a falling rock with the weight of a human or orc. Oh, I guess he was supposed to go this way. Alright. I thought he bugged and just decided, I'm just gonna go wherever I want now. Well, I guess I don't need that anymore. That's a trap. Still triggered it. Whispering. Use your smarts, he said. Like I'm supposed to figure out which college you get. Wonder if I can just... Yeah. Now normally I'd just beat the shit out of them, but I am going to Thieves Guild quest, and what other time am I gonna use my sneak? I don't think I was very good at sneak. Kinda thought that would be more quiet. They don't know I'm here, so there is that. Oh shit, they know I'm here. Alright, fight, swing. Throw wild punches. Alright, sneaks out the window. Time to fling fists. You think this web will stop me? Tear right through with my bear claws. Oh, come on, can I get a kill animation? Somebody needs to get German suplex before this is over. Also, I get like a boost to speed when I'm in combat for like the first 10 seconds or something like that. Makes you ridiculous. Traps on the ground. Anything else? Let's just hop on over that. And notice it's kind of dark here the moment I get outside of any kind of light source. Man, bear pig, strike skin. Member pig is real? I'm being super serial right now. Wait, wait. Okay, after I deal with these guys. Alright. Well, that's dealt with, and since I got a firelight right here real quick. This. It's my helmet. There we go. Hello, I'm Al Gore, and this is my man bear pig costume. It couldn't be more perfect. Alright, there we go. Here's that lovely blur again. You know, pretty sure I saw something to take that off. Probably should have looked more into it, so I could play in third person and not get a headache. Whoa. Come on, kill animation. No, I'm trying not to kill you so I can kill you in a cooler way. Why won't you let me German suplex you? You don't need it. Your life, that is. Or your spine. Hey, buddy. Oh, you're a mage. This changes everything then. Chill. Is he dead? Okay, cool. Now you. Nope, not happening. Alright. I need that kill move editor mod, so I can just make it so German suplexes are happening almost every time. And then you replay the popular gif of that, I think it was like the school janitor or grounds guardsman in that one anime with the robot girl and her cohorts. It was like comedy slice of life thing. The dude just picks a deer up and German suplexes it. I don't know the whole context because I didn't watch the show, but it's all I needed to see. Oh, I guess I didn't really confront him so much as, Brynjolf wanted him alive, didn't he? And I kind of fucked that one up. I don't want to find anything in there. There's nothing in here besides some gear. Wait, what about here? That's what happens when you swing first and ask questions later. You accidentally kill the guy you're supposed to keep alive for trade reasons. Hey, but he's dead, so now you don't have to worry about him betraying you. Oh shit. Okay, well, we're getting closer. I've got an idea of where we're going now. Then somewhere around here? No? Say I have an idea, but I guess I don't. Sway just a little bit. Yeah, there we go. All of that for 2 gold? Are you kidding me? Unlock chest empty. Well, you know, if you want experience. It's none of these. I don't think there's anything. I can't even loot him. He's just stuck in the wall. Alright, well, let's do this the smart way here. I'll not fuck it up this time. I'm fine with this. Gives me another chance to go try to German suplex somebody. That's always a good thing. Hey guys! I apparently still wanted to have muffle equipped, so ignore that. There we go. Quickly to the next target. You. It's your turn. Ha! He didn't even get to get out of the water. Oh shit, you're going flying. I don't think I can German suplex a spider, so you just gotta die real quick. If I could though, that'd be amazing. Do it to a dragon. Go up to Alduin and Sovngarde. Oops. Well, you know, I'm pretty sure people at this point know what's going on with the story. But yeah, go up to Alduin and Sovngarde. He's fucking devouring people and you just run up to him. No, I've had enough of this. German suplex. He wasn't ready for this. He doesn't have the limbs to deal to get out of that properly. I regret everything I've done. I don't even know if that dog was trying to attack me. I could have kept him. I could have named him. Give him food. Suplexed him. Possibly. Okay. Now. Let's save right here and see if I can't find a way to get him to talk. Oop.
Retire someday. Get myself an island.
Alright, you go deal with that shit. And I will... try to sneak up around behind here. What are these lovers for? I wonder.
No need to do anything rash. This isn't as bad as it seems. I was gonna tell.
Don't shoot me while I'm talking to him. Are you fucking kidding me? RKO out of nowhere. If that's a kill move, I'd love to. Alright, hold on. This needs to be dealt with. You're not gonna. I've still got muffle on. Why do I still have muffle on? I guess he's just okay with it if everyone else dies. Ooh. Alright, let's try this again. Hello. I'm here to talk to you.
This isn't as bad as it seems. I was gonna tell Mercy. I see you wish to be reasonable. The name of the person you want is Carlaya. Mercer never told you about her? Carlaya is the thief responsible for murdering the previous guildmaster, Gallus. Now she's after Mercer. Help? No, no. Look, I didn't even know it was her until after she contacted. Please, you have to. I don't know. When I asked her where she was going, she just muttered, "Where the end began."
Here, all right.
Take the Golden Glow estate deed as proof. And when you speak to Mercer, tell him I'm worth more to him alive.
Oh, I just remembered. I was thinking the whole Thieves Guild plot was resolved after you deal with a certain somebody who may or may not have just been stated recently. But there's a whole, like, what was it? A whole faction hidden within the Thieves Guild. Just like there is in every guild, I guess. What's that? You mean in this small faction that kind of exists outside the rules, there's an even smaller hidden organization using that faction for their benefit? And they just so happen always manage to find their way into superstitious stuff. Superstitious, let's try that word again. There we go. Want these. That too. I want it all. And I want it now. So you know. Bear sneaking, not that great. Bear combat? Totally fine. Oh shit! Hello. Speaking of. Are you trying to swap me with that torch? Send him sliding. Oh. Well, okay, I guess I'll just punch you in the face and let you slowly fall backwards. See, I'm not a murderer. I'm not killing them. I'm just punching them until they pass out. Oh. What? What just happened here? Oh, I guess there wasn't a bridge there after all. Fell through that tiny little crack. Can I not? Can I seriously not get up this? There we go. Just run along. Try that again. Run along a wall and press Y, and sooner or later you'll make it up anything. No! Damn it! You were so close. Well, you know that was pretty cool too. You tossed him over the freaking wall. You know, if he's out of the ring for a certain amount of time, he loses by default.
Time to end this little game.
Why, hello there. You can't win this. Yes, yes, yes! There we go! German suplex count at 1. I had to beat up every guard in that damn place, but I got one German suplex out of it. It was all worth it. Alright, now where am I heading to? Thieves Guild? Thieves Guild. Let's go talk to Mercifray about this lady who wants him dead. You almost missed it. It's a good thing you caught it. Hopefully we'll get more. It's especially ridiculous because you get to see them kind of like slip out of my grasp. My character never properly holds onto them to do it. It was the same way with, I don't know why this happened. Maybe it's because of the sizes, the character sizes. When I went to ride Odaving up into the sky, my character decided not to ride on Odaving, but next to Odaving. I hopped on my invisible Harley and rode it up with him. That's what it looked like.
Hmm? What did you need?
You two look almost the exact same, despite this whole character overhaul thing.
Need something?
And then you have this guy over here who looks almost the same as them.
Gullamai give up any information on our buyer?
Why are you two having a conversation while I'm trying to talk to Mercer? Fuck off.
Information on our buyer? No, it can't be. I haven't heard that name in decades. This is great.
You're telling me someone that didn't like you, that disappeared forever ago, is coming back and haunting you, doing terrible things to you? What shocker.
Destroyed everything this guild stood for. She murdered my predecessor in cold blood and betrayed the guild. After we discovered what she'd done, we spent months trying to track her down, but she just vanished. Carlia and I were like partners. I went with her on every heist. We watched each other's backs. I know her techniques, her skills. If she kills me, there'll be no one left that could possibly catch her. If only we knew where she was. There's only one place that could where she murdered Gallus, a ruin called Snowvale Sanctum. We have to go out there before she disappears again.
We?
Yes, I'm going with you, and together we're going to kill her. Here's your payment for solitude. Prepare yourself and meet me at the ruins as soon as you can. We can't let her slip through our fingers.
A lot of this we stuff going on here, buddy, all of a sudden. I was pretty sure you didn't like me. You go take care of it while I do some side jobs now.
Sorry, lad.
Like that he's like, if I die, nobody else would be able to catch her. No one else would know her techniques. But it's not her techniques that he knew. He knew where she killed somebody, and that's how he was able to find her. Like, I'm sure Brynjolf could have told me the same damn thing just by looking at the, you know, history of the guild. That's for Dawnguard. It's Solstheim. Oh, it's because it's a new quest. I gotta mark it. Every goddamn time. Looks like we're going on a bit of an adventure. The giant's version of a thinker. What they didn't show was after that pose, he took up a few steps forward, pulled that club off his back, and swatted somebody into the sky. I actually haven't explored around this region at all. Guess this is a good chance to get some landmarks over here. Hold on, what's going on here? Alright, I guess I'll just have to assume that I'm going to the right mark. Apparently my blue mark doesn't want to work. Maybe it's because it's overlapping with these. You see, the cold means nothing when you're dressed in a fur suit. That's... didn't plan that sentence out. When you're dressed in a... I don't know what to call these. From what I understand, they're called Higurumis. Then again, maybe there's some kind of specifics that I don't know about that... This isn't a Kigurumi, this is bear pajamas! How dare you! Hello, you people look a bit tired. Oh, wow. No one even gives a shit about this horse. Alright, well, new horse acquired. Didn't even need Shadowmare. I can just summon a horse by walking around a few steps. I'm just gonna go over here and grab this landmark real quick. Or so I thought. Never mind. Don't want to deal with the pain in the ass of trying to get back up after that. Rather just go get this place real quick. I already spent like the majority of the game. Most of my like last couple of days of playing this have been just me doing all the side quests I possibly could before doing any of the main stuff or the guild quests or stuff like that. Just because I'd wander off and stumble onto something and be like, alright, I'm just going to do this. I'm certain Carlia is still inside. No, I found her horse. Don't worry, I've taken care of it. That wasn't her horse. That was mine. Escape. Let's oh. Get moving. Never mind then.
Take the lead. Just make certain you keep your eyes open. Carlia is as sharp as a blade. The last thing I need is you blundering into a trap and warning her that we're here. That's enough of this unnecessary chatting.
I'd look into the lore more, but I've already done it. And, you know. I'm just here to become the head of the Thieves Guild. If you want the deep lore of the Thieves Guild, feel free to thief. How did you become a bear? Well, one day, I was a beautiful young male orc, destined to roam the world dressed in heavy armor, you know, swinging a giant axe around, berserker raging. And then, the next day, I discovered this set of bear pajamas. In fact, it was many sets of pajamas, but Out of all of them, the bear called out to me. Said, put me on and you'll become a warrior unlike anything you've ever been or could hope to be. Then bring up your fists and get ready for some German suplexes. It's gonna be a sick time. So I put on the bear pajamas, and now I'm a bear. And then if you want the more technical version of it, mod. I don't remember what the name of it is. I could look it up in my load order real quick if I wanted to pull it up. Kill the guy. Kill what guy? Here we go. Let's pull that over here. Should be in the caves, I think. Man, I got so many damn things in here. I don't know where it's hidden. Oh, it's just called Animal Pajama SE. So there you go, if you want to go find yourself a set of animal pajamas. They got all kinds, and I think my favorites are the bear and the frog. These weird giant googly eyes sitting on the front of it work really well with the frog too. Oh right, you're just gonna follow me. And thanks for the head up, or heads up, buddy. Kill Mercer, it's my duty. I mean, if I try it right now, he might not, we might not get to the quest properly. But... No, but, nothing. Look, yeah, it was him. Whoa, let's stay away from that for a second. Damn it. No, kill moves. Come on, kill moves. Now you're just gonna ragdoll over the place? That's fine. Where's the lever for this? And this is why I always keep torches. Oh, there it is. Right in front of my face. Shh. They won't see it coming. Bone chimes. Clever. Oh, one of them saw it coming. Kinda thought that was a stealth attack so it wouldn't make any noise. If I just swing wildly, sooner or later they'll get taken out. There are a ton of these guys down here. Why would Carlia come to hide down here? This place seems like it's more dangerous to her than it is us. She was by herself. You dick. Okay. Oh, down I go. I'll just hang out down here in the corner. Whoa. Please stop shooting arrows at me. Oh, it was you. Now there's rats again? What are you doing crouched? You're not even fighting. So much for this wee business. Mercer's the kind of guy to offer you or offer your services for helping somebody move. And then he backs out of it and just says, no, don't worry, this other dude's got it. You're all getting ragdolled. Nice foos! Aim it at nowhere and no one. I guess he was trying to open the way for me. He was really just trying to be helpful. Also, everyone here is a Deathlord. Deathlord. Don't know how that managed to come about. I don't need the stuff. You know what? But I'm a thief. I need to lockpick anyways. Oh shit. Do I need to go a bit more this way? No. Went too far that way. It was actually closer to the center. Oh, I think I just woke up. Oh, one more person. Mercer, you need to get out of the way. Told you you need to get out of the way. There we go.
We're on the right track.
Oh! I can punch right through that foos. That sounds like a bad time. Let's try to get this priest real quick. There we go. Why is the Astronarch still alive? Oh, because he wasn't the one who summoned it. Wasn't expecting a word of power hidden down here. Oh, it's a second word of disarm. Wait. Now disarm just- okay, hello, I apparently got this word too and didn't know about it. Coax both magical and mortal energies from your hapless opponent. So, vampire shout? But where's disarm? Here we go. I guess if you get more ranks in disarm, you can disarm more opponents. That's what I assume. Otherwise, what's the point in having another rank of it? Powerful punches. I mean, I could just go for the obvious joke and say I'm exercising my right to bear arms. Ha ha ha. I remember back during a history class, we ended up looking at a newspaper and I saw that as a comic strip. The dude had literal bear arms and it was like, alright. Little on the nose there, buddy. By little, I mean a lot. What's going on here? Am I not going the right way? Oh. Let's put a torch back on so I can see where the walls are. There we go. I'm still going the wrong way. I'm very good at navigation. This is why I kept doing side quests instead of story. Why go the right way when I can go the wrong way 20 times? Maybe I'll find a side quest. Or a treasure. There we go. Oh. Huh. Hey Mercer, you got a claw? Mercer? Taking your sweet ass time. Why are you trying to sneak still? Everything is dead. No thanks to you. Hate that guy. I mean, he looks cool.
Ah, it's one of the infamous Nordic puzzle doors. How quaint. Without the matching claw, they're normally impossible to open.
Oh, yeah? So bury your face in it. That'll help you.
Fortunately, these doors
he's trying to stick his own face in the claw holes.
Quite simple, really. Carlyle is close, I'm certain of it. Now let's get moving.
Oh, so I don't even get a claw. He just cheated. I'm disappointed in you. Oh! This is gonna look really weird when I'm holding the torch.
Do you honestly think your arrow will reach me before my blade finds your heart?
Give me a reason to try.
You're a clever girl, Carlyle. Buying Golden Glow Estate and funding Haunting Brew Meadery was inspired.
To ensure an enemy's defeat, you must first undermine his allies. It was the first lesson Gallus taught us.
You always were a quick study.
Not quick enough, otherwise Gallus would still be alive.
Oh shit, revelations.
Gallus had wealth and he had you. All he had to do was look the other way.
Did you forget the oath we took as Nightingales? Did you expect him to simply ignore your methods?
Enough of this mindless banter. Come, Carlyle.
Are you telling me the guy who was a pissant the whole time and then suddenly decided to work with me betrayed me? No way.
Crossing blades with you would be a death sentence, but I can promise the next time we meet, it will be your undoing.
But you can see her outline right there, dude. So much for dealing with her techniques.
How interesting. It appears Gallus's history has repeated itself. Carlyle has provided me the means to be rid of you, and this ancient tomb becomes your final resting place. But do you know what intrigues me the most? The fact that this was all possible because of you. Farewell. I'll be certain to give Brynjolf your regards.
Do I actually get a game over, or is this just gonna, something miraculously saves me because plot armor? Nope, he just kills me, okay. I deserve that. You did tell me to kill him. Oh. No, I'm fine. Hell with that. Blade to the throat doesn't kill me. Dead end. Easy. Love is over.
Easy. Don't get up so quickly. How are you feeling? No, I saved your life. My arrow was tipped with a unique paralytic poison. It slowed your heart and kept you from bleeding out. Had I intended to kill you, we wouldn't be having this conversation. My original intention was to use that arrow on Mercer, but I never had a clear shot. I made a split-second decision to get you out of the way, and it prevented your death.
Well, thanks. You seem a lot better than him already. Although you did poison me. So there's that. But at least you're the evil I know.
More than you'll ever realize. The poison on that arrow took me a year to perfect. I only had enough for a single shot. All I had hoped was to capture Mercer alive. Mercer must be brought before the guild to answer for what he's done. He needs to pay for Gallus's murder.
Well, you know, there's that, but he also needs to pay for fucking with me.
My purpose in using
bit more of an issue.
Sanctum to ambush Mercer wasn't simply for irony's sake. Before both of you arrived, I recovered a journal from Gallus's remains. I suspect the information we need is written inside. I wish I knew. The journal is written in some sort of language I've never seen before. Enther. Gallus's friend at the College of Winterhold. Of course. The only outsider Gallus trusted with the knowledge of his Nightingale identity. There were three of us. Myself, Gallus, and Mercer. We were an anonymous splinter of the Thieves Guild in Riften.
Well, we can find out who the bad seed of those three was.
Right now, you need to head for Winterhold with the journal and get the Here, take these as well. They may prove useful for your journey.
Alright, cool. I'll take some poisons for free. Wow, poison of every kind. Sooner or later I'm going to start dropping stuff or going back and dumping everything in an inventory storage somewhere.
Mercer lied to the guild, branded me a murderer, and slandered my name across his network of contacts. For 25 years I ran, never sleeping in the same place twice and carefully covering my tracks.
You two are a lot older than you looked. He was not expecting that.
Sting of fate as his life crumbles in front of him and he's hunted by the guild. I can promise you if it comes to that and my back's to the wall, I won't hesitate. He was a scholar, a master thief, and a natural.
Alright, yeah, you like him, I get it.
Into the Nightingales. We were very close. Gallus once said he felt comfortable around me, able to let his guard down. I can't help but think that I'm responsible for what happened to him.
Well, did you kill him? I don't think so. His life of thievery killed him, more than likely. Tends to be a dangerous profession. On up to Winterhold. Now let's hope it's not A, being attacked by vampires, or B, being attacked by a dragon, or C, both, because that's what happened last time. We're good.
Dragons breathing fire in the sky. Vampires brazenly attacking people on the street. It's the...
And the guard's talking about it. He's had enough of their shit, too. All these mythological creatures coming at us.
What is it? Can I help you with anything else? Carlia? Then she's finally found it. Do you have Gallus's journal? A problem. Let me see it. No, oh, this is just like Gallus. A dear friend, but always too clever for his own good.
This guy's voice is all over the place. They got like five voices that you just hear all over.
No. However, I know someone who might. The court wizard of Markarth, Calselmo, may have the materials you need to get this journal translated. Word of warning. Calselmo is a fierce guardian of his research. Getting the information won't be easy.
What exactly is a farmer? Well, considering you run into plenty of them by this point, don't really need that.
Besides the fact that there are only a handful of people in Tamriel that even
Oh, okay, so you wanted to be secretive.
Sadly,
got
we
it.
Never had the opportunity. Ironically, I pointed him in the same direction I pointed you. I'm only hoping whatever means he used to learn the language.
Alright, well, I've already dealt with Calcimo, so maybe he'll help me out and make this quicker.
I understand.
Let's go pay a visit to the court wizard who's really invested in dwarven ruins. Dude is all about them, especially since they're right inside the palace.
There's a small skeeter there.
Shit, that guard was talking about a location. Don't know if I really got it marked on my map since I went through the door too quick. And nope. Oh well.
Beware the region northeast. Across the river. Forsworn have taken refuge in Broken Tower Redoubt and Red Eagle Redoubt.
Pretty sure I've been to both those places already.
Good to see you. Then you were well informed. I am at this very moment on the cusp of completing my magnum opus on the subject. I'm calling it Calselmo's Guide to the Former Tongue. It will revolutionize the way we understand those ancient beings.
You mean they'll be, you know, vile, evil, cruel, still loving to coat their poison weapons, but they might also be a little bit smart?
That research represents years of personal toil in some of the most dangerous Dwemer ruins in Skyrim. You must be mad to think I'd allow...
Probably a little bit biased because Falmer killed me quite a bit when I was first going through this again. That little bit of poison on their weapons. You don't get to a healing item in time, all of a sudden you're screwed.
I've already provided you a key to the museum. I'm sorry, but that's as far as my generosity extends.
God damn it. Well, I mean, you don't seriously think that I'm gonna just leave this alone with that, Calcemo. Calcemo. Calcium. Oh, is this its own dungeon? Oh shit. Of course I'd have to steal. Why didn't I think I'd have to steal? Well, this is a problem. All my saves got reset down to zero. I was trying to go for 1,000. You know, not just saving willy-nilly, but 1,000, like, relevant saves. Oh, shit. Wish I had, like, a rock or something to throw the other way so they just... constantly be distracted by that. Get one of those dwarven spiders and chuck it at them. You think a regular spider's bag? A regular spider doesn't shoot lightning at you. I'll assume I just have to remain crouched the entire time. You know what? Here. It's like every time I do this, I forget about the blur and then I give myself a little bit of a headache just looking at this. There we go. But... I mean, what's the point of wearing the bear suit if I'm not going to show off the bear suit, right? Try not to take anybody out. Oh shit. What if I just hang out over here?
I guess I was just hearing things.
Yup, absolutely just hearing things. Saves me a lot of trouble. Actually a bit lost. So I actually need to go this way? What? Map is not helping me out very much. I assume I'll just keep following the path. Oh, German suplex surprise! Nice! Well, you know, I was trying not to kill anybody, but... you know, Probably just knocked her out. She's fine. Alright, well, we're actually just near it from the get-go, or so I thought. What? Damn. Maybe a bit more this way? When you get right there and you're just a little bit off. Alright, I'm too far. So then like right here. Oh, still too far. How about right here? Not far enough. But it looks like I'm right next to the spot I was on before. Alright, and that time it was perfect. You know what? Just give me a door hacking minigame. No one is here. Just a giant fuzzy skeever. Oh. Does not look like a place I want to be. Yep. Okay, just fucking book it through the hall. So I'll take this and do that. There we go. Well, I guess I could have just spammed heal. Speaking of using a spell, go ahead and do that. I love how easy it is to get illusion of just doing that. I don't even need to sneak to do it, I just fucking cast a spell and I get the EXP for free. Also, I've got a cool ability going on, I leveled up Restoration. So, whenever I cast healing spells, I get a little ward in front of me. Protects me for a good amount of damage. And it's also the reason I keep getting this warrior's flame that heals me or hurts somebody else or oh god. No, I'm so close. Just gotta be careful. Yep, she's distracted. Now I can go this way or get caught on some random object. Sure. Oh! Well, that's what that did. Okay. What? So he's unconscious right now, just like everyone else, that's all that was. Make sure to deal with him later. I'm certain he wasn't like a vital NPC. But, you know, reviving somebody isn't that hard, so thanks to console commands. So I'm fine with taking him out for now, and apparently taking myself out. Sure, why not? I'll take a puzzle cube. Well, my goal was to not kill anybody, and heard thunder and thought it was battle music starting. I was like, no, they caught me, how? Just by standing up? I say, my goal was not to kill anybody going through there, and I mean, I didn't. They're all just unconscious. So mission accomplished. Best sneak thief in Skyrim. How am I gonna get over there? Cannot sprint and jump. Noted. There we go. You don't have the items required to make a copy of the inscription. Okay. I mean, I got this dwarven puzzle cube. Maybe there's something hidden in this room? Okay, here we go. We got an office. It's gotta have something in here. Let me pull out a torch. Oh, I already have that book sitting in my chest. I got a chest for everything over in one of my houses, and then there was another time where I had all this loot and I went over to the Dawnguard thing. I was like, well, I don't want to run back to my house, and I just dropped it all in a barrel. Hey, there we go. Okay, he's not gonna come to life and start fighting me. I just take a roll of paper. Seems like the simple solution. No? Charcoal. You know what? That's what it's saying. It's saying charcoal and paper. That should be good enough. There we go. Turn to Enthir. Alright, that's great. How do I get out of here is the question. Probably doesn't involve having that on. Coming or leaving. I can't wait to see my wanted poster for this. Can I just like sneak around here? Can I teleport from here? That'd be great. He was in Winterhold, that's right. Wait, what? No, yeah, he is in Winterhold. Fast travel is unavailable in this location. Alright. No, that's fine. I just wanted to sneak my whole way down. Oh my god, there's no way out of here. Oh. No. It's not happening. Look, you're gonna have to die real quick so I can go looking around for an exit. Get impatient, sometimes it's best to just punch everybody and get the hell out. Can't wait to find out that there was no exit in here and I just had to go all the way back. like there's no lever up there. Nothing along here but a bunch of junk. I'm gonna have to run my ass back. Well, you know, never let it be said that all thieves are subtle. Going Bonnie and Clyde style on this one. Well, I guess I'd have to have a partner to do that. Going loud. Is there not a button I can hit to open this gate? That's not what I wanted. Take all that though. I just want to make absolutely sure that there's no way I can get this door open and save myself a ton of time. Why are you telling me to go back that way? Well, this is much better. You don't see shit. Nope, he found me. Hey, bye. Hopefully they don't follow me because that might be a problem when I go out here. Didn't really think that one through. Bye. Some guys come chasing after me. It's not for what you're thinking. Apparently now he's up at the College of Winterhold instead of down in the bar. Enter, part genius, part alcoholic. Okay, cool. It's not hanging up all the way at the top.
You want to work on something that's not officially allowed? Don't tell anyone you're doing it. You need something you're not officially supposed to have? You come see me.
Throughout Skyrim has been repeatedly verified.
You tell anyone what I told you and I'll
the meaning of these stones
inside out. Got it?
The prevailing opinion of Skyrim natives is that the stones are indeed magical in nature. While there is no direct evidence of this, it does seem likely.
I feel like I got caught up in a College of Winterhold thing when I was kind of just trying to get a thieves thing done.
Exactly match the markings or distribution of Skyrim stones. At present, there's no confirmation of any of the various theories surrounding the nature of these stones.
The best part of this is I can't foos him or punch him or something, I just have to wait.
Any individual stone is part of a larger, unobserved pattern. Also, their placement throughout Skyrim does not correspond to any known magical phenomena. The age of the stones themselves is yet to be officially determined. It has been widely assumed that they were placed during the Morethic era. Writings from that period, including those of Ysgrimor himself, do not mention the stones, and thus this idea cannot be...
Damn it.
Nonetheless, many are drawn to these stones based on the local stories describing them...
Seeing if I couldn't get on top of his head.
The college will continue to research these intriguing objects, and of course any findings will be relayed with all possible haste.
I'm here to help him. I'm his backup.
Was there something else? I suppose it would be inappropriate of me.
It's like watching you bounce up and down to those steps.
I simply won't. A rubbing, eh? Odd. I expected notes. I understand. Now, let me take a good look at this. Over here, please.
Alright, where's over here? How far is this gonna be, buddy? Oh, son of a bitch. And of course, it's the Raven Dragon. So cool, you get to see some of the extra dragons. And I guess we get to fight a dragon, yay. Also means I might just straight up die, or one of my NPCs might just die. The idea is just to get him to land down on the ground anywhere. Yeah. And you punch the dragon's butt 4 times, the butt's his weakness. Should have worn butt armor. And that's why dragons went extinct. Go ahead and grab that soul. Where's Enthar going? Okay. Now would you believe that just yesterday I was fighting those with a two-handed axe and getting immediately murdered trying to get just a few hits in. And I had to rely on power attack staggering. If it didn't, I was either going to get tail thwapped for most of my health or bitten for all of it. Or just beamed. Because the tracking on that beam is ridiculous. Relaxing walking simulator in an Arctic environment. Since I don't know where he's going. Oh wait, I have an idea. There we go. Forgot about that. Just save time. Just wait 1 hour real quick. Takes you a second and makes them go right to where they need to go. Does not work for Carlotta in the beginning though. She's gonna make you walk with her.
The mages don't let us go into college. They said it's not safe in there.
Well, if you're not a mage and you go into a place where magic is flying about, maybe bad for you, kid.
But highly disturbing. It appears that Gallus had suspicions about Mercer Frey's allegiance to the guild for months. Gallus had begun to uncover what he calls an unduly lavish lifestyle replete with spending vast amounts of gold on personal pleasures.
Does the journal say where this wealth came from?
Yes, Gallus seems certain that Mercer had been removing funds.
Oh, okay, I guess you're just here.
Without anyone's knowledge.
Anything else, Entha? Anything about the Nightingales?
Yes, here it is. The last few pages seem to describe the failure of the Nightingales, although it doesn't go into great detail. Gallus also repeatedly mentions his strong belief that Mercer desecrated something known as the Twilight Sepulchre.
Shadows preserve us. So it's true.
I'm not familiar with the Twilight Sepulchre. What is it? What's Mercer Frey done?
I'm sorry, Entha. I can't say. All that matters is we deliver your translation to the guild immediately. Farewell, Entha. Words can't express.
It's all right, Carlia. You don't have to say a word.
Hmm? All right, well, you know, it'd be nice if we could loot the words then. Okay. Guess that's not happening.
Listen, all I want is the truth to be revealed to the guild. They respected Carlia, and she deserves better. Do whatever you can, and I'd consider it a personal favor. If trying to rid yourself of stolen goods becomes a burden, I've been known to handle items of questionable
okay, so you also
from
fence.
Time to time, and I'll see what I can do. Meet me at my quarters.
Not what I was expecting.
Before Mercer can do any more damage.
It's not gonna help me. Something else?
We must hasten to Riften before Mercer can do any more damage to the guild. You've come this far, so I see no harm in concealing it any longer. The Twilight Sepulchre is the temple to Nocturnal. It's what the Nightingales are sworn to protect. Everything that represents Nocturnal's influence is contained. Now it seems Mercer's broken his oath with Nocturnal and defiled the very thing he swore.
So he's not getting along so well with the Knight.
I felt the same way when Gallus first revealed these things to
guess me. He's not getting Pokemon Moon.
Given time, you'll understand what I mean. As a Nightingale, I know.
Which I guess people got a hold of early.
I'll make for Rift. In the meantime, if the guild isn't willing to listen to
the entire copy, like how? It's amazing. Same time, terrible. Amazable.
Taking me up on my offer, eh?
Not taking you up on anything. I thought you were a shopkeep. They said it's not safe. I need to go become part of the Nightingales and then pass out. Different quest again. There we go. Ragged Flagon. Oh, right. Bar next to the Thieves Guild. If I go in through this entrance, are they going to be hostile towards me? I might just be a dead man. Yep, gonna have to go into the old-fashioned way. Damn. Hey there, Temple of Mara. So I didn't bother with the whole marriage thing in this game this time around. When I found out the first time what it was, I was like, oh. So you mean I have somebody who gives me 100 gold every day? And a free piece of food that I don't even bother going to my menus to eat? When I could just eat a potion. It's like, if you get a follower that's married to you, oh cool. You maybe get a little bit more dialogue. There's no build up to it either, it's like you just, I have a necklace on, oh. You happen to be interested? Alright, let's just go get hitched. Shotgun wedding.
I think some of these people are beginning to suspect who I am. Are you ready to face the guild? Keep your eyes open. I'm not sure what to expect when we enter the cistern.
Possibly death? God damn it. The idea was to make her go faster. I assume they're all waiting in the back. Ow, I just got hit by nothing. I'm gonna say, may as well hand delve in that puzzle cube while I'm here. Don't think he'll be much in the talking mood.
You better have a damn good reason to be here with that murderer.
Please, lower your weapons so we can speak. I have proof that you've all been misled.
No tricks, Carlia, or I'll cut you down where you stand. Now what's this so-called proof you speak of?
I have Gallus's journal. I think you'll find its contents disturbing.
Let me see. No, it can't be. This can't be true. I've known Mercer too long.
It's true, Brynjolf. Every word. Mercer's been stealing from the guild for years, right under your noses.
There's only one way to find out if what the last says is true. Delvin, I'll need you to open the vault.
Why, just a blessed moment, Bree. What's in that book? What did he say?
Apparently, whatever it is, a serious business.
From a vault for years. Gallus was looking into it before he was murdered.
Agate Mercer opened up a vault that needs two keys. It's impossible. Could he pick his way in?
That door has the best puzzle locks money can buy. There's no way it can be picked open.
I mean, he had this really magical cheat key.
Use your key on the vault, Delta.
Open a door that didn't even have keyholes.
Use my key, but the vault's still locked up tighter than a drum. Now use yours.
By the eight, it's gone. Everything's gone.
You've been robbed.
Get in here, all of you.
I can't believe you didn't see this coming. A guild of thieves getting robbed by a thief.
Away right now. We can't afford to lose our heads. We need to calm down and focus.
Do what he says, Vex. This ain't helping right now.
Fine. We do it your way. For now.
I mean, what was your way? Run after him with a dagger? Do you even know where he went?
If you see Mercer, come tell me right away.
Looking for wood. Well, well. If you happen across any other unusual trinkets like this, be sure to bring them to me. I promise it'll be worth the effort. It's worth quite a bit, actually. Quite a catch. There you go. This should make you smile.
800 coins worth of extra catch. Shit, if you're playing this on a normal run through, you need some money, come here. This place has it all. Sneak skills, lockpick skills, speech skills, pickpocket. All those things are really useful. And then you also get the skeleton key, you know, some cool armor, and a bunch of gold. Everything you could ever need.
I feared that was the case. From that last day, anything else? What? Nightingale? Was there anything else she told you? Trying to make Mercer look bad in front of me. Was there anything else? Then I have an important task for you. I need you to break into Mercer's home and search for anything that could tell us where he's gone. Aye. A gift from the... He never stays there. Just pay... Be careful. Just find
nice, see if you can find any evidence in his house. You'd figure if he's like as good of a thief as he's been so far, he wouldn't have left anything.
Museums, keeps, I don't... Without two keys, it's impossible to open. I have a key, Delvin has a key, and Mercer has a key. That's it. There are no other copies. Careful at Mercer's place. I don't want to lose anyone else at that time.
I dare Mercer to come back here.
I like how they never considered that maybe he had help.
I can't believe he emptied the vault.
One person betrayed us, there's no way two. Wait, what's going on here? Alright. Well, how do I get around that? What if I just break in the front door? Oh. Try to avoid getting myself any fines while I'm here. Just to not make extra work. Now, luckily, I saw somebody do this recently because my friend was doing this. Wait, where'd he go? Oh, I gotta go this way. He stared at me, said, no, that's not suspicious, and just turned around, went about his day. Guard does not give a fuck.
Guard might get nervous. Man approaches with his weapon drawn.
Well, wait a minute, how do I get in there then? Oh, that's how he did it.
This is Merce. No visitors. No way. Now piss off before you make me mad. You ain't got an... You try and set one foot in this yard and I'll cut it off. But I can't leave here. I'm supposed to watch his house. Wow. Sure is nice of you. Here, hang on to the key and don't let anyone in.
I really need to get in here. Why would you need to get in here? Look, don't worry. He needs you somewhere else. I need to get in there. Alright, you're a great upstanding fellow. Isn't that it? I swear he shot it and it came down. Oh, I gotta shoot the device. There we go. It's all about where you shoot it. So yeah, good luck guessing at that. Could take you a little while. What was that? Now you're mine. And now there are bandits, and I don't know why I have this thing on. Hello, bandits. I'm here to take some loot. Yeah, here we go. Aw, oh, damn it, I'm just gonna toss him. Oh, still. I mean, regular human tries to wrestle a bear. The bear's obviously gonna win. Guy did not plan that out very well. Alright, well apparently I can't break that. I put on the... Throat's dying. Should probably put on the torches is what I was trying to say. I don't think that spigot's gonna help me. But I'm gonna take it, because it's such a unique thing. Maybe it's useful. Doesn't look like there's anything down here. Hello, Mercer. Do you happen to be hanging around? Would you like to, just give up? Oh. Well, that solves that. I thought he was gonna have some puzzle involving the spigot. Oh god, I'm on fire. I thought he was gonna have some puzzle involving the spigot. No, he just has a hidden panel. Oh. Oh, and even that's dangerous. Well, let's get out of here. Is there no lever to pull to turn that off? No? Okay. No, that's fine. Oh cool, poison too. I assume that's just a regular glass sword, I don't need it. M, not certain how you managed to get your hands on that item we discussed, but I'm more than pleased. Thought you'd simply wait until it was being transported from Castle Dower to its final destination. But according to what I heard, it vanished right from their armory. Wish I knew how you were able to slip by the guards, bypass the portcullis? Unlock the armory door and break into that dwarven puzzle lock chest. You need to teach me a little trick sometime. I left your cut in the usual job spot and might have another job for you soon. Could be useful. Well, I guess if I want all the gems, I'm gonna have to take the bowl first. What do you know? That put me just over. Am I still too heavy? Well, you know. I have like hundreds of those back at the house, so I don't really need them. Drop me down in the sewers? It did. Alright. Right back into the Thieves Guild. Well, shit, he had it all set up. Hey, Brynjolf, I found your stuff. Also, you might want to seal up a hole back in that other area.
We've scoured the town and I've spoken to every contact we have left. No sign of Mercer. Shore's beard. He's going after the eyes of the Falmer? That was Gallus's pet. If he gets his hands on them, you can be certain he'll be gone for good and set up for life. Agreed. He's taken everything the guild has left, and to go after one of the last greatest heists is just an insult. I've spoken to Carlia. Made amends for
well, you know, he's a thief. He wants to go out big.
Now she wishes to.
To be fair, he's living a thief life properly.
We have no time to lose.
He is an asshole because he tried to kill me, but still. Gotta respect his ambition.
Yes.
Back from a job, huh? Hope it went well.
I promise you, all your questions will be answered. You just have to trust me.
Want to talk? Go ahead.
Time has come to decide Mercer's fate. Until a new guildmaster is chosen, the decision falls to you.
Aye, lass. And I've come to a decision. Mercer Frey tried to kill both of you. He betrayed the guild, murdered Gallus, and made us question our future. He needs to die.
We have to be very careful, Brynjolf. Mercer is a nightingale.
So he's pretty good at stealth.
Everything I heard in the stories. The Nightingales, their allegiance to Nocturnal, and the Twilight Sepulchre.
Yes. That's why we need to prepare ourselves and meet Mercer on equal footing. Just outside of Riften, beyond the southeast gate, is a small path cut up the mountainside.
Ooh.
The end of that path is a clearing.
I think we're about to become Nightingales.
I'd ask you both to meet me there.
Sounds good, right, Brynjolf?
I have some preparations of my own to make. I'll meet you at the stone.
All right.
I'm preparing to leave for the Standing Stone. What is it?
Her face kind of reminds me of Rudo from fucking Ocarina of Time. Where am I going? No, that's for Solstheim. Oh. The Shadow Stone. Who would have guessed? I got a mod in that removes all these stones, though. Wow, my throat is really dying.
Never should have come here.
Oh, knee to the gut, and flipped. That's probably going to be the last enemy, as far as I know, for tonight. Because once I join the Nightingales, I'm going to call it good. I'm starting to get a little bit of that ache.
I'm glad you're here.
And I'd prefer to be able to
this
sleep.
This is the headquarters of the Nightingales, cut into the mountainside by the first of our kind. We've come to seek the edge we need to defeat Mercer Frey. If you'll follow me, I'll try to explain on the way.
All right, take us there. Well, you're eager to follow me. Damn, Brynolf's right on me. I wonder if they'll make me put on the armor, if I can just wear my own armor into this.
So this is Nightingale Hall. I heard about this place when I joined the guild, but I never believed it existed.
The assumption that the Nightingales were just a myth was seeded within the guild on purpose. It helped divert attention from our true nature. What's wrong, Brynjolf? I can almost hear your brow furrowing.
I'm trying to understand why I'm here, lass. I'm no priest, and I'm certainly not religious. Why pick me?
This isn't about religion, Brynjolf. It's business.
Business with an ancient deity. You guys. Gonna say, you guys can take your sweet ass time. I'd actually like to get down there.
This is enough to make your head spin, eh?
Activate the armor stone. Not pick it up out of a chest. Damn, they are gonna make me put it on. Well, time to become Batman for a sec. Or Nightwing. Or Jack of Blades. Time's wasting. A little different from the other two I mentioned. Just a mask. Kind of reminded me of him. You guys are taking your sweet ass time back here. Alright, let's see real quick if I can switch back or if it's gonna tell me to equip it again. Oop, right past it. There we go. No, looks like we're good. Yeah. Yes, I am.
Wasted, and Mercer's still out there. Let's get this show on the road.
You appear ready for the oath.
Okay, yeah, well, I can tell where this is going. I'm just gonna go ahead and run. Can't use that right now. I can't pull a chain. Excuse me, I'm gonna need you to do it.
To hold any hope of defeat. Mercer, we must have Nocturnal at our backs. If she's to accept you as one of her own, an arrangement must be struck.
What sort of arrangement? I need to know the terms.
The terms are quite simple, Brynjolf. Nocturnal will allow you to become a Nightingale.
See, you guys are dressed horribly. People will guess that you're thieves or assassins. Nobody would expect a guy in a mascot suit to be an assassin or a thief.
Aye, there's always a catch. But at this point, I suppose there isn't.
And if they do ever catch sight of me, I can just say this is all a nightmare. You'll wake up in a minute.
What about you? Are you ready to transact the oath with Nocturnal?
Do I look ready? Yeah.
Stand on the circle. We'll speak when the oath is complete.
Yes, we will. Now get over there. God. The thing that makes it so they talk more and they have a lot more to say, but
still out there.
Also causes them to stop and talk to you when you don't want them to. Means you gotta be careful about walking near them. I put up my dukes, I'm ready for anything.
call upon you, Lady Nocturnal, Queen of Murk and Empress of Shadow. Hear my voice.
Ah, Carlia. I was wondering.
All right, hello. Again. Lose magical sentient darkness that's somehow also light.
My lady, I've come before you to throw myself upon your mercy and to accept responsibility for my failure.
You're already mine, Carlia. Your terms were struck long ago. What could you possibly offer me now?
I have two others that wish to transact the oath. To serve you both in life and in death.
You surprised
me. Whoa. I didn't sign up for this cult. I'm not drinking the Kool-Aid.
My appetite for Mercer's demise exceeds my craving for wealth, Your Grace.
Revenge. How interesting. Very well. The conditions are acceptable. You may proceed.
Lady Nocturnal. We accept your terms. We dedicate ourselves to you as both your avengers and your sentinels. We will honor our agreement in this life and the next until your conditions have been met.
Very well. I name your initiates Nightingale, and I restore your status to the same, Carlia. And in the future, I'd suggest you refrain from disappointing me again.
I mean, you say that, but it seems like it was Mercer who did the disappointing. Actually, I mean, he succeeded at what he wanted to do. So maybe that's why she's talking shit on you.
Mercer's true crime. Mercer was able to unlock the guild's vault without two keys because of what he stole from the Twilight Sepulchre, the skeleton key. By doing this, he's compromised our ties to Nocturnal and, in essence, caused a... Well, yeah, all of us possess untapped abilities. Once you realize the key can access these traits, the potential becomes limitless. Good. Then you understand why, if the key isn't returned to its lock in the Twilight Sepulchre, things will never be
the same. Well, I mean, the options were either the guild gets it, three of us get it, or no one gets it. The option for me taking it wasn't there, but it's what's gonna happen.
Very true. In our line of work, it's quite rare. Before we depart, Brynjolf has some business to discuss.
I suggest you talk to Carlia first.
Listen, she told me to talk to you. What is this?
One last piece of business we need to settle before we go after Mercer. The leadership of the guild. Carlia and I, thanks to your efforts, Mercer's treachery as a result. We both feel that you have the potential of replacing Mercer as leader of the Thieves Guild.
I've been at this game a long time, my friend. A long time. I've stolen trinkets from nobles and framed priests for murder. I'm good at what I do. Maybe even... I've never been one to lead. Never desired it, never cared for it.
I literally just joined, so I don't know why you're suddenly saying I'd be better suited to this.
We have a bit of an errand to run before your coronation. Then it's decided. When this is all over and Delvin's contacts assure me that we've regained our footing in Skyrim. Until then, I've been poring over the plans you brought us, and I'm convinced the eyes of the Falma are in the Dwarven ruins at Urk. Carlia and I will meet you there. Prepare yourself, lad. This will be a fight to remember.
Aye. And some of what Carlia said is starting to make sense. Mercer may... Old Delvin kept calling it a curse, and we all laughed at him. Looks like the joke's on us.
There you go. Make fun of the crazy guy, suddenly the crazy guy's right, and you're the fool.
Sorry, okay. I've got important things to do. We'll speak another time.
But you know, that's probably like the final quest for this, or close to it. But I've actually, like I said, I got a bit of an ache going on, so I'm gonna call it here. But we'll come back to finish this quest line at the very least. I still need to do Dark Souls like I started a month ago, so that'll happen at some point too. Just, you know, when I finally get to it, it's gonna be kind of a loose schedule for the next while. I guess you wouldn't really call that a schedule then.
Sorry, lad. I've got important things to do.
A lot of impromptu. Now though, thanks for sticking around. Have a good one. See you around. And this.
So it's to the pain then.
Really? Can't even do an assault. Well, of course I couldn't do an assault move on them. You think he'll get back up and be fine with it? Fight me, nerd. Wow, she's just booking it. She wants nothing to do with this. Wow, the crit strike just took him out immediately. Alright. Well, that's that. I got violent with him. I thought I could maybe pull off a kill move real quick on him. Didn't happen. Now I just got myself in trouble. Good thing I'm not saving. Alright. See you around.